This test is for elite cross-country skiers and competitive recreational athletes. This test tells us about the distance skiing capacity and how it's developed over time. We can do this long aerobic capacity test either using pole walking or using roller skiing with classic double poling and skating techniques. From this test we can define aerobic and anaerobic threshold and person's VO2 max. Test should be done 2 to 3 times in a season in order to analyze the athlete's physical condition and to get direct training guidance based on the existing situation. This kind of long aerobic capacity test consists of 3-minute loads which are increasing progressively until the athlete is exhausted at the end. In roller skiing protocols, only the speed is increasing and we are using constant uphill gradient, but on pole walking test both speed and uphill gradient is increasing throughout the test. During the test we are measuring blood lactate from the fingertip between every load after 3 minutes. Also, expired breathing gases are measured during the test using an ergospirometer. In addition to these physiological parameters, we are recording videos from every workload during the roller skiing test. And with these videos, we can analyze really important technical parameters that are related to economy of the roller skiing technique. At the end, athlete will get a report of the test which contains information about these physiological parameters as well as technical details of the skiing performance. Based on these parameters, athlete will get guidelines for the heart rate zones as well as training guidelines for future trainings. These videos which are collected during the training are also stored in our coach tech system from where athlete or coach can go and check the videos and these technical parameters afterwards with his personal credentials. In my opinion, this is the one test athlete should do if he's doing only one test.